Well, when you think about it, if you don't need, if you have solar and everything, you don't need power.
Right.
You could live here for $150 a month during the time you're open.
I sifted through a desert in my heart to find all the oases where they are.
My name is Barbara. This is my husband, Lucas. We are the camp host at Arkalon Park in Liberal, Kansas.
That's where I am, Liberal, Kansas. Who knew I'd find love in a place like this, but I love this campground. It was not very easy to find, but I'm going to give you the info you need at the end. And as far as the rest of it goes, I'm just going to let Barb and Luke tell you all about it.
We love it here.
This is actually owned by the city of Liberal. It was donated to Parks and Recs. The reason why they call this Arkalon Park, there used to be a town over here called Arkalon. The railroad train track went where you come in up on the hill. That used to, there used to be a switchback there. And the train used to run back about 3 miles back behind us. They had a big flood back in 1911, I think. The train bridge got washed out. I think they built this bridge back in the 30s.
It's called the Mighty Samson of the Cimarron.
That's actually a freestanding bridge. The concrete pads are like 60 foot in the ground.
Right now it's kind of brown because we're just coming into summer, but it's a beautiful place to be in the midst of summer, even when it's hot. We water night and day out here because we don't get a lot of rain or a lot of moisture, summer or winter. But it gets really, really pretty and a lot of grass. It's all the trees are green and budded out and the grass is beautiful. It's just a quiet, nice, comfortable place to be.
A lot of wild hog, deer. You can see the turkey come through here of a morning and evening.
A whole bunch of them usually.
Every day?
About every day. Yeah. It depends on how many people we have in the park. Sometimes they'll skirt around because, you know, they're a little shy. But if it's pretty quiet, they'll show up in the mornings and the evenings.
And we got lots of nature trails here, too, that she can go walk. River walks. There ain't much water in no river anymore. It kind of dried up with the sands of time, you might as well say. There are about 7 different trails out in the back over there. Just where you can split off and see different parts of the landscape. We've got a bird sanctuary down there too.
Yeah, that's true.
For bird watchers and stuff.
How many spots do you have here?
We have 13, I believe, camping spots and kind of undetermined amount of tent spots, which people can park on even if they're not in tents as long as they don't want or need any electricity or water.
So what they're calling a tent site is basically what some other campgrounds would call rough camping or just a non-electric site. You know, you don't need hookups, but you don't have to be in a tent. I'm not in a tent.
We have free firewood. That doesn't happen a lot. I know people have been surprised.
Nice bathhouse, good clean, good hot water. We clean them every day, sometimes 2 or 3 times a day.
I'm going to interject here about the showers. They are beautifully hot with good strong pressure, but they stay on for only 4 seconds. Like literally, I counted 4 seconds. It's not a huge problem. You just have to keep pushing the button, you know, and every time you push it, it goes for 4 seconds. You can get plenty clean and warm with these showers, but it's just a little weird. Hey, it's free.
We got a nice pavilion for like recreational gatherings.
We have a nice play area for the kids, and during the summer people will bring their kids out even during the weekdays, but mostly on the weekends.
As soon as I saw this place, I thought, what a perfect place for like a schoolie family.
Kids love to come out here and play.
I have to say something about these two tornado shelters. Everyone I talk to who lives here tells me that they've never even seen a tornado. You know, Kansas, I actually looked it up, and Kansas is only number 13 on the tornado-prone states list, which was a surprise to me, I guess, because of Wizard of Oz. So far this year, Alabama and Georgia have been the hardest hit. Texas gets a lot of twisters, too, but I think being down here in the river bottom, it seems like that would make this park a pretty unlikely target. But Barbara says they have the shelters mainly because visitors want them, because they've seen the Wizard of Oz too.
Is there a limit to how long someone can stay?
No, not really. We've had people stay all summer long. So, and we're upset when they had to leave.
Yeah.
When we closed last winter.
We're trying to talk them into opening it up year round.
Their main concern right now is figuring out the water, because they don't want it freezing up during the winter and people being stranded down here if and when it ever snows here again.
Yeah.
You know, it's quite a climb to get out of here, and they were just afraid that people couldn't come and go as they needed, and as well as the water.
Right now the park is open from April 1st through October 15th.
If they were open year-round, would you just live here year-round?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. I love it here. You get to meet people from all over the United States.
Yeah. We get a lot of travelers, overnight travelers. We've had four or five different couples from Canada.
This year, so far, we've had more from Canada than we had all of last year.
Yeah.
It's really been awesome to meet the people. A lot of them will say, next time we go on a trip, we'll try to plan to come through here again, you know? Looking forward to some of them that we met last year.
We open our gates at 7 o'clock of a morning, and we close it, lock the gates at 10 o'clock at night. But if you need out, you can let us know and we will go open the gates.
We can make arrangements for people who like to work and stay out here.
Yeah.
And if you need to go to work or come in after 10, we work with you and try to make arrangements for you to come and go as you need. What, we have some last year that were building some kind of a building, and they were they came out and stayed most of the summer with us.
They was building a biodiesel plant over.
Yeah, that's what it was.
Over off of Mead Lake Road.
Speaking of plants, what's that plant that's over there?
That is a natural gas plant.
It looks like the Emerald City.
It does. It does. I like to think of that when we come in, especially at night, and it's all lit up back there.
Which is especially interesting because Dorothy's house is right up the road here in Liberal.
There are several ponds up there, two main ones. This year, we did the deck on the first pond, and it's beautiful, and they did a great job, the city workers. We went out on it the other night and just stood there and looked at the ponds, and it was really neat.
Remember the show on Golden Ponds?
That's kind of what
it looked like, sitting there when the sun was going down, the glistening of the sunset on the water, and the ducks in the background. The thing we didn't have was the loons.
Okay, now here's the part you've been waiting for. How much does it cost?
We charge $15 a night for 30 amp and $20 a night for 50 amp. Tent sites is $5 a night.
Remember, a tent site just means you don't need hookups. It doesn't mean you're a tent. You can put a vehicle there, like I did, and it's $5.
Well, when you think about it, if you don't need, if you have solar and everything, you don't need power.
Right.
You could live here for $150 a month during the time you're open.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
There isn't any kind of a discount for staying the whole season, but it's $5 a day. Do you really need a discount? And even if you need hookups, $15 a day, what's that, $450 a month? That is reasonable.
I'd love to do this forever. I mean, it's...
As long as they'll keep us.
Yeah, as long as they want us here, we'll be here for sure. I feel like this is my destiny. I love doing this, you know?
She's got the gift of gab.
I do.
And it makes it easier for her.
I've been frozen in the snow.
Beautiful, calming green.
Like a torch near me, you thaw me in the glow.
This is what we call our little oasis in the desert. You come off a big sandy hill down into the river bottom.
Yeah.
And there's beautiful green trees down in there in the summertime.
It's our oasis for sure.
Yeah.
It's a lovely thing to see things through your eyes.
It's my oasis too. Anytime I come through Kansas now, I'm going to be staying at Arkalon Campground. I don't even want to leave, but I have to leave.
If you do decide you want to come here, don't use Google Maps, don't use Apple Maps. It's all going to steer you wrong. I'm going to put the directions that worked for me in the description, along with a link you can use to reserve your spot at Arkalon Online. I know Barbara and Luke are going to make you feel right at home when you get here. Meanwhile, the trek continues for me. I'm still a long way from Boston. I'm going to keep looking for more cool places as I go across the country. Places just like this. Or like this. Have you seen this one? I'm going to go watch it again. See you over there.